Join us in Palawan. I'm David Saldran. This is Executive Class. It's touchdown in Palawan and back in El Nido for the first time since the pandemic began. But this trip will be different. Instead of heading straight to the islands like I've always done, I'm staying on the mainland in a newly opened resort called Lihim. And I have no idea what to expect from a place that, like its name, has been kept a secret since it recently opened. So, getting to Lihim Resort is a bit like getting to your resort in Boracay Island, for example. You first have to drive from the airport to the pier, and from the pier, you take a boat to the resort. But of course, it's a private boat. Let's go. Wow, but nice, huh? This location is nice. You might want to stop a bit for a few minutes, just to enjoy the scenery, of course, before you ride a boat. Yes, this is what I expect from a luxury resort. Your own boat, your own butler, and above all, your own time. You do what you want and when you want. Now that's my kind of holiday. Few seascapes in the Philippines, maybe in the world, are as breathtaking as the islands of Bakwit Bay and the unique silhouettes of its ancient limestone cliffs. Boat ride is so enthralling. Time flies quickly. All right, that was easy. Just about 5 minutes from the pier to Lihim Resort. So you're wondering, why even take the boat? They're so close to each other. Well, that's because there is no main road that connects the two. And that's a good thing. And that's why it's called Lihim. It's a secret hideaway. What is that?
Dayun.
In Palawenyo. Or in.
Yeah, it's one of the dialects here.
Hello. Hey, Jeanette. Thank you. Wow. Welcome. Thank you.
So,
this is Lihim. Though now, it's no longer a secret to me. Yet, because it opened at the height of the pandemic, the resort is still at that early stage where it's still word of mouth. Lihim is a flagship property of the young and growing Araw Hospitality Group, a Filipino brand of unique boutique properties all over the country. Their sprawling luxury resort in El Nido is located amidst a tropical forest on a mountainside, overlooking Calaan Beach on the mainland and the famous islands of Bakwit Bay. Within this huge beachfront and mountainside estate are only 16 luxury villas, most of them tucked within thick forest cover for extra privacy. I'm off to check in to one of the larger villas hidden on top of a hill. Ooh, wow. Okay, this is where the road ends and the path to my treetop villa begins. Now, it's a very steep grade, so be careful, especially at night. Although, I understand they'll be reopening their funicular to get you from bottom to the top in faster time. But you know what? I don't mind making this trek every day. Just look at this view. Just look at it. I'm glad Lihim decided to build on the natural slope of the hillside instead of flattening the land. Although it's a challenge to climb these terrace steps, at least they didn't ruin the delicate ecosystem. Plus, because of the terrace terrain, the view is unique from any elevation you find yourself at. Thank goodness I was going downhill.
have no idea how many steps that was, but I don't know. I was so focused on the view, I lost count. But the good news is, when they reopen this funicular over here, you can get from bottom to the top and top to bottom with no sweat at all.
So inquire first before booking your villa and make sure to pick the one with a location and view that's best suited to you.
Whew, that was a workout. All those steps, but look at your reward over here. It's this fantastic treetop view of Buckwheat Bay. And yep, waiting for you, your own private plunge pool. It's perfect.
Duli is one of the 8 hilltop villas of Lihim, but it's most popular with guests who require their own plunge pool. And I can see why. The infinity pool has a spectacular vista of the sea, framed by the trees. But even without the pool, I'm perfectly happy here, especially with the quality of air and these bird's eye views, which you can enjoy in the privacy of the spacious veranda shaded by a canopy of trees. The view from the bedroom is just as amazing. Wraparound floor to ceiling glass doors, make sure of that. Although you're in the middle of a forest, the room is equipped with high-speed Wi-Fi and modern amenities. And the bathroom? Incredibly big. You even have a choice between a large indoor tub or an outdoor shower under the trees.
Okay, so I'm checked in and I'm ready to enjoy this place. Now, the good thing is, even before I arrived, Mark, my butler, already discussed my itinerary, right, Mark?
Yes.
So what do we have for today?
So you will be having a lunch at Palo Maria by 12 noon.
Right.
And then later on by 3 p.m., you will be having a sunset cocktail.
Oh, yeah, right. Make sure you schedule a massage for me. Buy wine here at the villa.
Absolutely, sir.
I'll see you later, Mark.
My pleasure, sir.
Pleasure. That's exactly what you get with all this privacy and spectacular hilltop scenery. But if you insist on being closer to the action and a few steps away from the beach, Lihim offers seaside villas too. A secluded corner of the beachfront is Sabang. And though it's not among the larger ones in the property, it's got a huge veranda facing the sea.
Now let's take a look at Sabang. This is only one of 3 seaside villas in the property. So if you want a villa right at the very edge of the water, this is it. Plus, you get this, uninterrupted views of Kadlao Island. Ooh, this looks really romantic. Just imagine having your outdoor bath with your partner at sunset. That's a direct view of sunset overlooking Buckwheat Bay. Don't worry, what happens in Lihim stays in Lihim. That's why it's called Lihim. It's a secret.
You don't have to be secret lovers to enjoy staying here. A lot of guests like the villa's location close to Ghana. Lihim's main restaurant and cocktail bar on a patio by the swimming pool and beach.
So we're done with the hilltop villas, the seaside villas. And now let's check out one last villa I need to show you. And this is our presidential villa, the most luxurious of them all.
Yes, it's another steep trek uphill. The top villa of Lihim is, well, at the very top of Lihim, literally on the mountaintop.
Almost there. But come on, just look at this view that's waiting for you. This is the highest spot in Lihim. The Arao Villa. This is a presidential suite, and this is what you get.
The 146 square meter Arao is not just a villa, but more like its own resort in the most secluded and highest section of Lihim. It was a private home of the owner and Arao chairman, John Henry Lulier, before he opened it up to guests. It's a sanctuary within a cloud forest with a huge wraparound balcony and private plunge pool with panoramic views of the bay. And being this high up in the mountain, no one else can see you or bother you here.
This view is so astounding. I wouldn't mind just spending the entire day out here. But why do that when you can get the same view inside the room? Yep, look at this.
It doesn't get any better than this. And that includes the space and amenities available at the Arau Presidential Villa. Like all the other villas, Arau is adorned with art, antiques, ephemera, and souvenirs from the frequent travels of Mr. Lulier. It's no wonder most guests prefer to stay in throughout their holiday, because once you're up here, you're in some sort of self-contained slice of heaven. In fact, you can skip meals at a beachfront restaurant altogether and book any one of the hilltop gazebos and secret lounges for lunch or dinner.
Okay, this walk is making me really hungry. And I'm just in time for lunch. And here, at Lihim, you have different choices of where to have lunch.
Palo Maria Gazebo on the mountaintop of the resort is perfect for private events, or in my case, an intimate luncheon with Ogi Lontok of the Arau Hospitality Group. We couldn't have picked a better spot to dine and chat about the flagship resort of their young company. Or for that matter, picked out a better lunch menu. All the grilled seafood their team of chefs prepared were fished straight out of the waters below that same morning, including these humongous oysters. Incredible and yummy. Although my tummy's satisfied, my curiosity isn't. I'm dying to know why Arau decided to build a luxury resort far away from the legendary island resorts of El Nido.
Augie, you know, a lot of people, when they think of El Nido, it's always the islands. The resorts, at least for luxury side of El Nido, has always been the island resorts, no? And you guys are building a luxury resort on the mainland. How did you even find this place, and what makes this place special?
No, you're absolutely right, David. I think the charm of El Nido has always been in the islands, and we know that. However, the owner, with his his vision, he's a visionary, and when he saw this property, he thought he could create something different, something different from El Nido, a totally different destination, away from the islands, and that's why he created Lihim. No, which is connected to the mainland. However, we also have different properties in the islands where we bring our guests to. No, so not to deprive our guests from the beauty of the islands of El Nido.
So it's kind of like the best of both worlds.
Correct.
And what do those two worlds be that you try to combine?
Again, at the islands, of course, it's the beautiful turquoise water lagoons and the sprawling white sand beaches. Where here you have the charm of the forest and the hilltops, you know, being submerged in all this nature all around you, yet really close and with the beautiful view of El Nido. And the town of El Nido, the town has its own charm, that local flavor that a lot of the tourists that visit the islands sometimes neglect when they go straight to the islands. So that is something unique and quite interesting to the travelers now. You know, they want to get the feel of that local flavor, if you like.
Ogie has a point. I've been to El Nido several times, but never bothered exploring the town. Which is unfortunate because the new strip of restaurants, bars, and watering holes of the mainland offer visitors, mostly foreign flashbackers, a different, more exciting version of the secluded island experience.
But apart from that, you have the private islands. I think that's what excites me most about Lihim, is that you have these secret islands. Tell me about that.
Well, that's the whole part of our of the name, no, Lihim. Secrets. We have all these secrets that we provide to our guests. And you're absolutely right. Part of the attraction is the islands, our beach lounges that we've created at the islands, away from Lihim Resort, right, from the mainland. We would set up a venue where we can provide their butler, of course, a private chef, and a server. This is private, so only our guests will be able to enjoy these destinations.
So it's like providing guests two locations in one vacation.
Yes, and we have, well, several of these. So throughout their stay, they would be experiencing different destinations.
Oh, perfect. So I can't wait. That's the next thing I have on my itinerary, right?
That's right.